Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Naomi T. Grant. If this is your first time here, if this is not your first time here, thank you guys so much for tuning back in. I know it's been a minute since I posted on my YouTube channel, and you know, I want to say sorry because I really prided myself in how consistent I had recently been. But to be quite honest, with everything that's been happening in this country, I truly just needed a break. I had no desire to sit in front of a camera and talk about makeup and do my makeup. It just seemed like it wasn't needed. It wasn't the time for it. I really didn't have it in me to do. And you should follow me on Instagram, because I was on Instagram for a little bit, even though I did take a week break off of that. But I was on Instagram sharing different ways that you could, you know, donate money to different causes that we're going to fight against racial injustice in this country, as well as petitions to sign and movies to watch and books to read to educate yourself. I was a lot more active on there than I am on here, but I will link all of that down below if you guys are also trying to find ways to help. If there's so many different ways that you can donate your time, your money, or your signature to. Also, just since we're on this topic, we will begin to start voting very, very soon. So really take the time to use the power in your vote. With that being said, like I said, I had a really hard time with figuring out ways to create content in this time that was meaningful to me. So this video I'm really, really excited about, because it is all about black owned makeup lines, and I just felt like it gave more purpose into the content I was creating if I was supporting something that I was really passionate about. I think it's very, very important for us in this time as black people, if you're black and you're watching this, of course, to, and if you're not black, I think you should do this too, but use our money and support black owned businesses. We need to have more black millionaires and billionaires in this country. We need to support people like us. They create products for us. They understand us. We don't have to worry about not being represented in these spaces. And I really wanted to take some time to showcase some black owned beauty lines, because in my experience working as a freelance makeup artist, not only selling products to clients, but working with clients, I find quite often, way too often, so I have brown and black women sit in my chair and feel like they never really found, you know, could find products that work for them, and they always felt so insecure in the beauty space because there were just not products on the market that catered to them and represented them. I wanted to create this video because I wanted to share to those people who maybe felt that way, or maybe people who just want to support more black-owned businesses. I wanted to showcase some of these really great black-owned beauty lines in this video and some more videos to come. To be quite honest, after doing my research, I found so many, and it'll be too many to talk about in this video here. So this will be a regular thing that not only I speak about on this channel in this way, but I'll be using more of them in my videos. Although I have in the past, so I definitely recommend checking out some of my videos in the past. If you guys can tell, I'm really passionate about supporting black people on my platform because I'm a black woman. While we're talking about black things, in this video, actually, I am wearing everything that I have on my face is from a black owned makeup line. If it's not from a black owned makeup line, it's from like a black content creator who did a collab with the makeup line as well. So I will be linking that all down below. I also will be doing a video doing a face full of products owned by black owned makeup brands. So if you guys are interested, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell notification so that you're notified every time I post, and thumbs up if you are interested in content like this so I can keep creating it. So let's get right into the video. I wanted to start off by talking about a brand that is pretty well known on social media, and if you're someone who's into makeup, it's kind of hard to even avoid this brand because it's legit everywhere. It's Juvia's Place. They're now actually sold in Ulta, which I think really did like allow more people to know about the brand. But this brand for me is not only known from like their really great eyeshadow palettes and their pigments, but for their flash sales. They have a sale like so often. I've never paid full price for any item from Juvia's Place, so I definitely recommend if you want to buy anything from Juvia's Place, wait till they have a sale, because then for not only because it's cheaper, but you'll be able to buy more. And I think that that's part of their marketing tool. They make sure that they always have a flash sale, sale for a day, everything's 50% off, all of our eyeshadow palettes are $10, whatever it may be. They do that to increase sales and it works. Some of their top selling products or most popular items are their Nubian palette. I will pop it below. I will pop it in the screen somewhere. Their Zulu palette, and they recently launched a line of complexion products. It is called the I Am Magic Collection. The line recently launched a foundation. It's a velvety matte foundation. I haven't tried that, but I've heard great things. Every time I've seen people use it on camera, it looks really great. It's supposed to have a velvety matte finish to it, and they have so many shades that I honestly feel like it's actually hard to find your shade. So I recommend, if you're into purchasing her foundation, look around on YouTube to find people who have similar skin tones as you do to find the right shade. And I will be buying that foundation soon, so look out for a video, because I will be doing a video showcasing those products as well. That line actually has a concealer as well, a liquid concealer. Their liquid concealers, and I've tried it, they're really, really good. And not only are they really good, but a lot comes in the tube. Like, I was actually surprised at the size of the product, so I recommend that. And they also have foundation sticks or contour sticks. You can use them as contour. I love a contour stick. If you've watched any of my videos in the past, like my makeup tutorials, I use a contour stick all the time. I think it's probably one of the easiest and best ways to contour. If you get a good one, it just really does change the game and changes like how long it takes for you to do your contour step, because anybody trying to be standing in the mirror doing their makeup for like 30 minutes, like, I don't have time for that. So yes, I recommend that. And their powders, their setting powders are actually really good. One of them reminded me a lot of the Benai Banana Powder, which used to be very, very popular. It was probably one of the only setting powder shades that worked for black women. And they have one just like that. Everything on their website is a good price, even without a sale. So I definitely recommend, if you've never tried anything from their brand, try some of the products that I spoke about, some of their most popular items. Another brand that I want to speak about is Colored Rain. I love this brand. I have known about this brand for a while. When I used to work at Ricky's, I think I spoke about working at Ricky's in a previous video, but I worked at Ricky's maybe 6 years ago, and they sold their liquid lipsticks there. Their liquid lipsticks is one of their like first items, the first few items that they launched for the line. And one of my favorites, and I spoke about it in my last video, is the Cherry Blossom liquid lipstick. It's one of the best red lipsticks on the market. This brand really, really gets pigmentation very well. And they recently expanded from having liquid lipsticks to stick lipsticks, which all look really great. They have great nudes, great pops of colors, but also the eyeshadow palettes are like, oh my god. Their Queen of Hearts palettes is probably one of the most popular ones. I think that that palette really like put them on a map, because if you look up that eyeshadow palette, you'll see people reviewing it of all different skin tones. Like, it's just a great eyeshadow palette. Like, they have great shades. No matter your complexion, you'll be able to find something in that eyeshadow palette that works for you. It's so good. Another popular eyeshadow palette that they sell is the Safari palette. I was so mad they restocked it on June 19th. And I forgot to like put a notification on, or like an alert on my phone, and I missed out on it. So I definitely went on the website and said, email me when you guys have it back in stock, because that eyeshadow palette is so nice. And the price point isn't too bad. I think it's like $30 or a little bit less than $30. I've spent $44, $50, $55. I almost spent $100 and something for eyeshadow palette, but sorry, Pat McGrath. I can't. I want to and I will, but not today. So the prices are great. The pigmentation is great. And another thing that I need to mention that I think is amazing, you can buy single shades to their most popular eyeshadow palette. So for the Safari palette, I could buy every single shade if I wanted to. And the pans are a little bit bigger than the size of the palette. And that is something that is, I love that. So many brands have eyeshadows in, like, you know, their palettes that they don't sell individual shades of, and it's sad because sometimes you only want the palette for like one or two shades, but they don't sell it individually, so you have to buy the whole freaking palette. And it's like, do I need more nudes or more gold color things? Like, oh my gosh. So I really love that. So if you want the Safari palette, but you're not really crazy about all the other shades and want one or two, I definitely recommend. Brand that I'm gonna mention is a smaller brand that I've heard about a few years ago, but they changed the name of the brand. But I wanted to mention it because I actually was working with a client recently, and she wanted to find more products that were more natural because she wanted to get a everyday makeup. The next brand that I'm gonna talk about today is Uma Beauty. So this is a brand I have not tried yet personally, but I've heard great things. When this brand launched, it like went insane on social media. Like, it was everywhere. Big beauty influencers all over were speaking about this brand, and I love that it's a black owned brand. Like, yes, come through. Like, they were ever the most popular items is the Save What foundation. They do have a full on complexion line that I recommend you guys try if you're looking for a foundation. They have great shade range as well. Their badass icon matte lipsticks, they look so cute. Like, the packaging is cute. The lipstick shades are really nice as well. The owner of the company is actually the woman behind the Pull Up or Shut Up campaign. The campaign is basically calling out different brands for them to let us know, let the public know, how many black people that they have employed within their company, specifically in their corporate office and the decision-making roles. And I love the campaign. I love that she's using her platform to call out brands and them to make changes within their brands. I think that we're in a time right now where companies are starting to look within and are starting to see some of the flaws that they have created throughout the years and really are looking to make changes. And I think the companies who have participated in this Pull Up or Shut Up campaign, who don't have many black people working in those roles, are in a position where they're like, we need to make a difference. I guess this is not okay, but we're gonna do what's right. So I just want to shout that out. She's using her platform to really make a difference. So I love that. I want to speak about today is actually the lip bar. The brand is known for the liquid lipsticks from some of the first items that they launched. That was the first makeup brand that I know of that sold lipsticks in bold colors, like light blue and like literally colors that you would look at and be like, why would you put that on your lips? Before Kat Von D did it and Jeffree Star, is that his name? I think that's his name. Jeffree Star? Yeah, him. That guy. She did it before all of these other brands kind of picked up on this trend of having like bold, unconventional, untraditional colors on their lips. And that is what I feel really pushed the brand to the forefront, like bold, fun color choices. The packaging is also really edgy and fun, which I really love, because it's one of her most recent collection launches, and I have to speak about it because it's freaking genius. It is called the Fast Face. So basically, as the title says, it's a way for you to do your makeup really fast, and all of the different products are made for you to be able to just pick it up and find everything that you need in that one product. So you can either buy the products individually, or you can buy them in a pack of all of the products in one, and the total of that is $99. Now, it seems like a lot upfront, but $99 on makeup is nothing. If you go to Sephora or MAC, just randomly buying things, you can spend that much in one shopping trip, you know? What that collection has, it has a foundation. The foundation actually comes in like a tube with a brush on the bottom. So you pump it out and the foundation comes out on the brush, and then you can apply it on the face. It is so easy to use. It's freaking genius. They have tons of different shade ranges as well, so you can find any shade range for your complexion. She also has a quad that you can get, and the quad has a setting powder, a highlighter, a blush, and a bronzer. So right after applying your foundation, you can set your foundation, you can bronze your skin, you can put blush on, you can put your highlighter on. She has a brow pencil. You can use your eyebrow pencil to fill in your brows, liner, and of course the lip products, of course. But this collection is genius. You don't know how many times I get clients tell me they just want to find a way to be able to do their makeup really fast and easy. And oftentimes when I'm doing my makeup on clients for special occasions, I can recommend some of the products that I'm using, but for the most part, a lot of the products are not meant for everyday use. It is more so meant for like a special occasion, like long, like hour long wear. So this collection is genius if you want like a nice everyday makeup. If you're looking to buy anything from the brand, I would say some of the Fast Face products are really great, and the liquid lipsticks are awesome. Oh, and the lip glosses are really nice too. I've tried them as well. Love the lip gloss. I'm gonna close it off by talking about a brand that I've used for years, and I don't think a lot of people speak about this brand. Social media is such an interesting place because a lot of brands, if you're not really like big on social media and you don't like send your products out to beauty influencers, so many really good brands kind of get forgotten about. But this brand has so many good products, so many tried and true for me, and it's Iman Cosmetics. I put my first cream foundation, like one of my first foundation products, from Iman Cosmetics. They used to sell the products in Duane Reade, which is now Walgreens, and in Target. I do not believe they're sold at those two places anymore, but you can buy directly from her website, also on Amazon as well. This collection was founded by the model Iman. The reason why she created the brand is because she used to have to go on castings and go on photo shoots, and she's a supermodel, and makeup artists didn't have makeup for her, and she was tired of not looking good in front of the camera. She created this product, this line, purely out of necessity. Some of my favorite products are her luxury pressed powders. I have it right here. These are my tried and true. These are, for me, these are like dupes to the pressed powder from MAC, but they're so much more affordable, and I love the color choices. They're just so, so, so good. I use them all the time. Like, I probably use them in almost every makeup video that I've ever done. The Luxury Moisturizing Lipstick. I have it on today. Love it. The shade that I'm wearing is the Iman Nude. It is one of my favorite nude lipsticks. I would definitely recommend using a lip liner with it, like a brown lip liner, because it is really like light brown kind of nude, but it's just so good, and it's creamy, and it's, I love it. One of my tried and trues. Oh, second to none foundation stick. They do still have it. That foundation stick is the truth. If you're someone, I always like cream products. That's just personally me. One of my all-time favorite products, and I'm kind of like hesitant to bring it up because I've had so many issues with this product, is their Luxury Contour Trio. So it's a trio, obviously, but one of the shades is a dark shade that I use for bronzer, and I've used for bronzer in the past, and it is such a beautiful color. I wish I can get a whole like compact with just that color, because that's honestly the only color that I use. It has a little bit of shimmer in it. It is just so freaking gorgeous. But the reason why I'm hesitant to bring it up is because the packaging is so bad on it. And it's so weird because it seems like the packaging for that is the same as the packaging for this. Like, you know, a product like this where that's how it is. But I have dropped that product one time and it shatters. It shatters. Like, obviously it's a different formulation than these pressed powders, but I purchased that product three times. I've never hit pan on it. I've never finished the product, and I've always had to purchase it over because it breaks. So Iman, if you are some way, somehow you find this video, please figure out that packaging, because I love the product and I have to purchase it over and over again because it breaks, and it makes me so sad. Like, it's made me not want to buy it again, because I'm like, I don't want to keep having to buy something that I know is going to break. And like, I'm just so nervous using it, because if I drop it one time, it's going to break. And like, breaks the first time it drops, then it's like, But that's, I'm kind of going on a tangent because I'm really upset about that. Seven makeup brands. I think that's enough for now. If you guys love videos like this, make sure that you like, subscribe, thumbs up this video. Want to see me do a full face using black owned makeup lines? Make sure you subscribe, because that will be my next video. And I just hope you guys enjoy content like this. I will be making it a point to showcase more black businesses and black owned everything, honestly, on my channel, whether it be from fashion or cosmetics. It could be honestly anything. Like, I recently bought a few products from the Honey Pot, but it is like a feminine hygiene line, and I will be doing a review about that in the most ladylike way possible. But I just think it's important to purchase from Black-owned businesses, speak about it, because a lot of these products are really good and they do make products for us and they know what we need. And I just really want to, the only way that I feel like I'll be able to create content going forward is using my platform to speak about things that I'm passionate about and also have it be really fun. So that's a nice positive outlet for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and definitely make sure that you guys look at the description bar down below, because I have tons of goodies down there. I will be including everything that I use on my face today. What else would I be including? Yeah, place for you to donate, petitions for you to sign, books for you to read, movies for you to watch, and everything that I mentioned in this video, all the different brands that I mentioned in this video, and some of the top selling products and products that I wanted. So yeah, the description bar is gonna be popping, so make sure that you guys check that down below. Also, check out my website, NaomiTGrantBeauty.com. I will be posting on there daily, so I'm very excited about this, because I just love my website. I think that is a really fun way for me to stay in touch with you guys, do reviews on products really, really quickly without having, like, you know, do a video, edit, have my makeup on. It's just a quick way to kind of get messages out to you, and I have really great content on there already, so make sure that you guys check that out. And I will see you all in my next video. Take care, be well, take care of yourselves and your mental state with everything that's going on. Make sure that you guys are taking a break when needed, and I will see you guys in my next video.